Hello and welcome to the session. In this session, we will discuss the graphical method of solving linear programming problems. The graphical method of solving linear programming problems involves two main steps. The first one being to find out the feasible region and the feasible solution. Now after this, our next step is to determine the optimal solution from the feasible region. Now, let us define the terms feasible region, feasible solution, and the optimal solution. First, we have the feasible region. It is the common region determined by all the constraints including the non-negative constraints. So, for a linear programming problem, when we graph all the constraints, the common region determined by all these constraints is the feasible region. Now, next term is feasible solutions. These are the points within and on the boundary of the feasible region. When we have the feasible region with us, then the points which are on and within the boundary of the feasible region are the feasible solutions, and any point outside the feasible region is called an infeasible solution. Next term is optimal solution. Any point in the feasible region that gives the optimal value which is the maximum or the minimum value of the objective function is called an optimal solution. Now, since there are infinitely many points in the feasible region that satisfy all the constraints, so to find out the point that gives the maximum value or the minimum value of the objective function, we would use two theorems. First, we have the theorem 1. According to which we have, let R be a feasible region for a linear programming problem and let Z equal to AX plus BY be the objective function when Z, that is the objective function, has an optimal value, that is the maximum or the minimum value, where the variables X and Y are subject to constraints described by linear inequalities . This optimal value must occur at a corner point of the feasible region. And this corner point is a point in the region which is the intersection of two boundary lines. So in this theorem we have that if we have that R is any feasible region for the linear programming problem and Z is the objective function given in the form of AX plus BY, then the optimal value of the objective function, that is Z, must occur at the corner point of the feasible region. Now the second theorem is, let R be the feasible region for a linear programming problem and let Z equal to AX plus BY be the objective function if the feasible region R is bounded, then the objective function Z has both a maximum and a minimum value on R, and each of these occur at a corner point the feasible region R. So we are given R is the feasible region and Z is the objective function, which is in the form of AX plus BY. If it's given to us that the feasible region is bounded, which means that it can be enclosed within a circle, then the objective function Z will have both a maximum and a minimum value on the feasible region R, and each of these values would occur at the corner point of the feasible region. Let us now consider an example of a linear programming problem and find its solution graphically. Consider a linear programming problem to maximize the profit function given by Z equal to 50x plus 18y subject to the constraints given as 2x plus y less than equal to 100, x plus y less than equal to 80, x greater than equal to 0 and y greater than equal to 0. Let this objective function be equation 1, these constraints be 2, 3 and 4. Now we are supposed to solve this linear programming problem graphically. Now since we know that the graphical method of solving a linear programming problem involves two steps, in which first we have to find out the feasible region and the feasible solution, and in the second step we find the optimal solution from the feasible region. So first of all, let's find out the feasible region. And as we know, the feasible region is the common region determined by all the constraints, including the non-negative constraints. So for this, first we have to graph these constraints, and the common region which would be determined by these constraints would be our feasible region. Now, to graph this inequality, first we will graph the equation 2x plus y equal to 100. This line joining the points A and B is the graph of the equation 2x plus y equal to 100. Now we will see that if the origin satisfies this inequality too, so for x equal to 0 and y equal to 0, in the equation 2 we have 2 into 0 plus 0 less than equal to 100, that is 0 is less than equal to 100, and this is true. Therefore, this means that the origin O with coordinates 0, 0 lies in the region given by the inequality 2, that is 2x plus y less than equal to 100. So the region containing the origin and below this line AB is the solution set of the inequality 2x plus y less than equal to 100. So this region, so region R1, is the region for the inequality 2x plus y less than equal to 100. Now next, we need to graph the inequality 3, which is x plus y less than equal to 80. For this, first of all, we graph the equation x plus y equal to 80. So this line joining the points C and D is the graph of the equation x plus y equal to 80. Now, for x equal to 0, y equal to 0, in equation 3, we have 0 plus 0 is less than equal to 80. That is, 0 is less than equal to 80, which is true. Therefore, this means that the origin lies in the region x plus y less than equal to 80. So, the region below this line CD containing the origin would represent the inequation x plus y less than equal to 80. So, this portion represented by the red color given as R2 is the region x plus y less than equal to 80. Now, next we have the non-negative constraints x greater than equal to 0, which would be the y-axis and the region on its right-hand side. And in the same way, the constraint y greater than equal to 0 would be x-axis and the region above the x-axis. Now that we have graphed all the constraints, so we can easily find out the feasible region. As we know, the feasible region is the common region determined by all the constraints. Now at this point of intersection of the two lines, x plus y equal to 80 and 2x plus y equal to 100, we have point C. So this region OBCDO is the feasible region. Now let's find out the coordinates at this point of intersection of the two lines, that is the point C, which would be obtained by solving the equations x plus y equal to 80 and 2x plus y equal to 100. So next we have solving 2x plus y equal to 100 and x plus y equal to 80. For this, we would subtract these two equations. This would give us x equal to 20. Now to find the value of y, we would substitute x equal to 20 in any of these two equations. So we have 2 into 20 plus y equal to 100, or you can say that y is equal to 100 minus 40, which is equal to 60. Therefore, we have x equal to 20 and y equal to 60. So, we get the coordinates of point C as 20, 60. So, we have got all the vertices of the feasible region. And we know that these points O, B, C, D and the points within this region and also the other points which are on the boundary of this feasible region are the feasible solutions for the problem. Now, after we have obtained the feasible region and the feasible solutions for the linear programming problem, our next step is to find out the optimal solution for the problem. And for this, we follow the corner point method, in which our first step is to find out the feasible region, and we have obtained the feasible region as OBCDO. And as you can see, this feasible region is bounded. Now, in the next step, we find out the corner points of the feasible region, which could be obtained either by inspection or by solving the two equations of the lines intersecting at that point. We have the corner points of the feasible region as O, B, C, D with their coordinates. So the corner points are O with coordinates 0, 0, B with coordinates 50, 0, C with coordinates 20, 60 and D with coordinates 0, 80. Now from this theorem stated, we have that the objective function has an optimal value and that value must occur at the corner point of the feasible region. Also, as the feasible region R is bounded, then this objective function has both maximum and the minimum value, and each of these would occur at the corner point of the feasible region. But as we are supposed to maximize the profit function Z, so we will find only the maximum value of the objective function at any of the corner points. And that would be our optimal solution. Now to do this further, we will evaluate the objective function Z at each of these corner points. Now our first corner point is point O with coordinates 0, 0, and for this point the objective function Z is equal to 50 into 0 plus 18 into 0, and this is equal to 0. Now the next corner point is the point B with coordinates 50, 0. At this the objective function Z would be equal to 50 into 50 plus 18 into 0, and this is equal to 2500. Next corner point is the point C with coordinates 20, 60. For this the objective function Z is equal to 50 into 20 plus 18 into 60, which would be equal to 2080. Now next corner point is the point D with coordinates 0, 80, and for this the objective function Z would be equal to 50 into 0 plus 18 into 80, and this is equal to 1440. Now as these values of the objective functions calculated at these corner points, as you can see that 2500 is the maximum value. So let us denote this maximum value of the objective function by capital M, and this is equal to 2500. This is the maximum value of Z, and let small m be the minimum value of Z, which is 0. Since we have obtained the maximum value of the objective function Z as 2500, and this is at the point B with coordinates 50, 0, so we say that the point B with coordinates 50, 0 is the optimal solution, and Z equal to 2500 is the optimal value. So this is how we solve a linear programming problem graphically. First we find the feasible region for the problem and the feasible solutions, and then using the corner point method we find the optimal solution for the problem. This completes the session. Hope you have understood the graphical method of solving a linear programming problem.